gonna tell you what took over the world, though. What took over the world, it was two things. It was three things. Fila flip-flops.
With socks.
Two was the girl wearing the tennis skirts and the baby tees. And three, the Fila pullover down coats flipped inside out with all the Fs. Inside Fs all over it.
Life-changing.
The heritage of the brand actually began in tennis. That combination of white, red, navy, and Bjorn Borg, a guy who stepped on the court with these colors, really changed the way people viewed sport at that time. And it was deep into the urban market, in the streets of New York and Detroit, New Orleans, Houston, Atlanta. There became this kind of interesting zeal to connect with this brand. And those colors, that white, navy, red, became kind of an icon and a symbol of aspiration.
I remember when I bought the shoes, the Fila tennis, the cream with the red and blue flag on it. It was just a sleek design. Back in our days, it was kind of looking at a long tail Cadillac. The cream shoelaces, the F box, the box on the toe, just the different colors on the blue and the red F with the flag. It was something that just had us hooked. And then when we first bought our pair, we'd sit in front of the store and just look at our shoes for maybe like 10 or 15 minutes, like, damn, we got them. Oh my God, I can't wait to put them on. When you saw Fila back in the day, you just knew it was the shit. Excuse my language, but that's what it was.
So back in the day, obviously, it was a tennis, performance tennis shoe. And when things start taking off in different parts of the culture, they took this performance on-court tennis product and they thought about applying like real natural leathers to it and really taking more of a lifestyle spin to it. Fila cream.
What's your first memory of Fila?
Finally, I left Adidas.
I'm Filipino, so we would say it was like short for Filipino.
Forever I love Atlanta. Fila, Atlanta is a marriage that exists, a bond that exists, and it goes back at least 20 years.
Philadelphia was also big too. Stackhouse was just the man before Allen Iverson. He was everything to the Sixers.
The Fila acronym, it's become something that's personal. Over the past three decades, people have taken ownership of the word Fila and the brand and what it means to them.
A lot of people don't understand that, you know, Fila had a big accessory line back in the day too.
I had several pairs of Fila sunglasses. I don't know who made them at that time, but they were so badass.
I had this awesome Fila visor that I loved. The headband, it was the mesh, you know, the traditional headband, and the visor was plastic and it Velcroed to the front. I wore that thing all over the place.
My dream was to always hustle and go get the Fila Thunderbird. Before it's all said and done, I'm gonna hunt one down and buy one.
We've gone to the archives to find iconic images with culturally relevant people that are all representing the brand with more than just footwear. We have accessories, we have apparel, we're a part of bigger initiatives.
Another thing about Fila, maybe even number four, is Grant Hill.
And that was definitely a point in time that I can really remember Fila doing something. That was like a stake in the ground.
I think it was a dope partnership too, because like they kind of represented each other. Grant Hill wasn't the flashy kind of guy. You know, he had his one little crossover move, but it was about, you know, getting to the point, getting business, getting wins, getting buckets. And that's what it was, you know what I mean? And I think, you know, Fila is the same thing. It's not the flashy in your face brand. I think it was just it was a perfect match.
Favorite Fila shoe from a nostalgia standpoint would be the all black Grant Hill 2.
My favorite Fila shoe would have to be the Grant Hill 1, especially that's when he first signed to Fila in 95. Just the colorway, the white, blue, and red was so sick when he came onto the court with them. I thought, and now the laces just lace all the way to the back. I thought it was really sick.
My fondest memory was begging my father and my grandfather to get me a pair of the Grant Hill 2s in the OG colorway. I went to Foot Locker. They were actually sold out. I have to say I had to settle for the Concord Jordan 11.
I remember hearing this mother talking to her daughter. You're trying to get me to pay this many dollars for that shoe just because it's a Fila? And she's like, Mama, these aren't Filas. These are Grant Hills. Like, don't you understand? And I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I went over to go look at the shoe and I'm like, oh my God, these are the shoes that Grant Hill wears.
Basketball for Fila was a turning point. In the mid-90s, Grant Hill ultimately was the crescendo, and it put us in a league that that I don't think anybody could have ever imagined. The company sold a million pairs of the first Grant Hill shoe. There was an insatiable appetite for anything connected with white, red, navy, Grant Hill, the superstardom of this young athlete out of Duke that was to be the replacement of Michael Jordan.
I was a big fan of the cage. I can remember being a kid and Reebok was the only other manufacturer that made something that was specifically designed for outdoor basketball, whether you were on a brand new court or some of the crappier courts, which unfortunately were the ones I was playing on. I actually still have memories of trying to slide my foot in there without untying the shoe and lacing it up properly and ripping right through this plastic piece as I tried to slide it on my heel. Even ripped, I still wore the shoe, I loved it.
I remember getting a pair of Fila cages, and I wore them so much. They were the coolest thing.
A good example of the way Fila kind of adds an extra level of creativity to their products. They took what was just going to be an outdoor kind of court basketball shoe. They added on this whole molded cage to the back of the shoe, which really became the iconic look. The cage itself, we built it in memory foam for the newer versions.
Fila, along with other brands, had a lot of staying power in the early to mid 90s. People were wearing Nike, they were wearing Adidas, they were wearing Reebok, they were wearing Alesse, they were wearing Fila, they were wearing an amalgam of brands. And they were wearing that because they all wanted to be different. Everybody had wanted to have a different sense of style.
The Fila brand itself has always been one that had a unique story.
It was not only an athletic brand, it was also into lifestyle. So not only would you see it on athletes, but you would also see people out in the streets and these different people that were influencers in my neighborhood, you know, they were wearing them as lifestyle. And it was cool to see, you know, velours and, you know, all the accessories that they had, and just seeing it on all these fly guys, you know, really meant a lot to me.
I mean, when you think about Fila, it goes back to, it's a heritage brand. It was one of the first footwear brands that you've seen worn in urban communities from top to bottom. There's not many brands that can tout that today.
But there are things that happen that you can't take away from people. You know, you can't take championships away from Michael Jordan. You can say what you want about him. And as far as in Fila and sneaker culture history and the whole fashion history, those are like three things that are undeniable, at least where I'm from. And I'll put those stories up against any story with any brand.